marriage to Gvendolen. Algernon wants to know why Jack and Sigurd kissed when little in the description. From little, Cecily, with honest love. Jack explains that his real name is Jack Wendy, squire in country, but he assumes the name Earnest when he ventures to the city for fun.
What's Cecily?
Cecily is his ward. Algernon confesses that he, too, employs deception when it's convenient. He visits an imaginary friend, adult friend, I mean Bunbury, when he needs to, when he needs an excuse to leave the city. After that, Lady Bracknell and Gvendolen arrive. When Algernon asks, describes Lady Bracknell in another room, Jack proposes to Gvendolen.
Standing.
So I found that you are no doctor. 7 or 8 thousand a year. In investments, chiefly.
That is satisfactory. And I am sleeping.
Well, actually, I have lost both my parents.
To lose one parent, Mr. Morton, can be regarded as a misfortune. To lose both looks like a carelessness. And who was your father?
Well, I cannot tell you, actually. The fact is, Lady Bracknell, I told you that I had lost my parents, but it seems like they have lost me. I don't know who I am by birth. I was found.
Found?
Late Mr. Thomas Cadew, a gentleman of very charitable and kindly disposition, found me and gave me the name of Worthing, as he happened to have a first-class ticket to Worthing in his pocket at the time. Worthing is a place in Sussex. It's a seaside resort.
Where did the charitable gentleman who had the first-class ticket for this seaside resort find you?
In a handbag.
A handbag?
Yes, a black leather handbag with handles to it. Quite an ordinary handbag, in fact. But, Lady Bracknell, may I ask you now, what would you advise me to do? I think there is no need to say that I would do anything in the world to ensure Gwendolyn's happiness.
I'm strongly advising you, Mr. Wharton, to try and acquire, to produce some relations as soon as possible, and try to find your one parent of either sex before the season is quite over.
Well, actually, I don't see how I could possibly do that. I can produce a handbag! It is in my dressing room at home. Will that satisfy you, Lady Bracknell?
Me, sir? What has it to do with me? You can hardly imagine that I, or Mr. Bracknell, should allow our only daughter to marry into a cloakroom.
Well, but...
Good morning.
Good morning, Lady Bracknell.
Cecily, I'm sure.
You're having some strange mistake. I'm not little. In fact, I'm more than usual tall for my age. I'm not a project brother. My cousin Earnest. My wicked cousin Earnest.
Oh, I'm not really wicked at all, cousin Cecily. You mustn't think that I'm wicked.
How haven't you been in a double life, pretended to be wicked and been very good all the time? That would be hypocrisy.
Of course, you are reckless.
Glad to hear it.
Now that you mention the subject, I should admit I've been a very bad character.
Oh, I don't think that you should be so proud of that, though I'm sure it must have been very pleasant.
It's much pleasant to be near with you.
I don't understand how you're here at all. Uncle Jack won't be back until Monday afternoon.
That's a great disappointment. I'm obliged to get up by the first train on Monday morning. I have a business appointment that I am anxious to miss.
Couldn't you miss it anyway in London?
No, the appointment is in London.
Well, I know how important it is not to do a business engagement. But still, I think you had better get your Uncle Jack arrives. I know he wants to speak to you about your immigrating.
Oh, I what?
Your immigrating. He's sending you to Australia.
Australia! I would sooner die.
Well, he said you would have to choose between this world and the next world and Australia.
Well, the accounts I've received of Australia and the next world are not particularly encouraging. This world is good enough for me, dear cousin Cecily.
Yes, and you good enough for it.
I'm afraid I'm not that.
How thoughtless of me. I should have remembered that Ron is going to have an entirely new life. He needs regular meals. Would you like some?
Thank you. Might I have a bottle first? I never have any appetite unless I have a bottle first.
How much on me?
I'm just going to have a bean rose.
Why?
Because you are like a bean rose, dear cousin Cecily.
That's not right that you talk to me like that. My governess, Miss Prism, never says such things to me.
That Miss Prism will never shot sight to do already. You are the prettiest girl I ever saw.
But Miss Prism says that all good books have a snare.
There is a snare that every beautiful man would love to be caught in.
I wouldn't care to catch a sensible man, though I should know how. I should know how to talk to him.
About it.
Thank you.
standing for? Who I am?
I'm afraid that the news will not altogether please you. You are the son of my poor sister.
You mean Mrs. Moncrief?
Yes, and consequently, Elgin's brother. Elder brother.
Elgin's elder brother? So, I have a brother after all. I always knew I said I had a brother. I always said I had a brother! Elgin, you young scoundrel, you will have to treat me with more respect in the future. Well, you have never treated me like a brother in all your life.
Well, not till today, young boy. I must admit, however, that I was quite out of breakfast.
Yes, but now, what is your real name?
Oh, I have totally forgotten the point. And your decision on the subject of my name is remarkable, I suppose. Lady Bracknell, what is my real name? Let me know the worst.
Being the eldest son, you naturally present after your father.
Yes, but what was our father's Christian name? Algy, can't you recollect our father's Christian name?
Earnest John.
Gwendolen, I always told you that my name was Earnest, didn't I? And finally, in the end, after all, it is Earnest. I mean, Earnest, after all.
My old Earnest! Yes, and won't you be deceiving me?
No. You know, Gwendolen, it's a terrible, terrible thing for a man to find out that all his life he has been talking nothing but the truth. Can you forgive me?
Yes, I can, and I think you are sure to change.
My own one.
Cecily! At last!
Gwendolen! At last!
My nephew, you seem to be displaying signs of duality.
On the contrary, Aunt Augusta. Now, for the first time in my own life, I finally realized the importance of being Earnest.